Hi, I'm Rachel. I'm Minimalist Machinist on Instagram. I said I'd do some walkthroughs on Seamly2D, this free open source software that I use for pattern making. I'm currently making a block in Seamly2D and have had to teach myself how to use it. It can get a little overwhelming, and I'm a software engineer and I find it a bit baffling sometimes. So I thought I'd use what I've taught myself to try and give you a bit of a walkthrough of the software and maybe get you started on it. The first thing you're going to need to do is go to Seamly.net and download the software that's relevant for your operating system. While I'm here, I thought I'd mention some resources as part of this website that you might need. The first thing I wanted to mention is that when I came to this site originally, when I started using this software back in September, didn't notice that there was a menu at the top of this screen, and that's because this website's not built very well. Can you see the background goes and you can't see the menu? And that made me miss that there were any user manuals or videos or anything like that, and that's why I got started kind of teaching this to myself without any resources. I wanted to point out a couple of things here. If you wanted the user manual for Seamly2D, which I recommend you do, clicking that will take you to this page, and you just choose whichever ebook you want for your language that you're using. This also is a wiki for Seamly2D, which is quite detailed. It can feel a little overwhelming at first, but we're only going to be diving into this for little bits of information, and everything's figure outable, so don't worry too much about trying to understand the whole thing straight away. I certainly don't, and I've managed to make some part and pieces using it, so that's the first thing, and that will take you to whatever language PDF that you click through to. It's a good little reference PDF. I mean, it's not completely exhaustive, but it's useful if you get stuck with a certain tool. From this website, you can also find their official video tutorials, and that takes you to YouTube. They've got a YouTube channel. Just note that Seamly2D used to be called the Valentina Project. If you're looking for resources for using this software, they might still be under this name, just like the YouTube channel is. So yeah, keep an eye on that. The only thing about these videos, although they're great, there's no audio, so you don't understand why you're choosing certain tools to use. You don't understand why you're doing it in a certain order. I think that's a language barrier thing, because they didn't want to translate them all. You mainly just need the user manual and the videos, and that's pretty much it.